This is the mighty Susitna River. It drains the south and west slopes of Mount McKinley. The flats are very large, running from about 250 miles north and south to 100 miles east and west. It's the Ohio of Alaska. Old Denali, mother of mountains, Mount McKinley itself. We're about 100 miles from it as we fly on our way toward Rainy Pass Lodge and photograph it with a telephoto lens. It's 20,300 feet high, rising almost from sea level, from a plateau less than 2,000 feet high. It is the highest mountain on Earth, above the height from which it starts. This is the Skwentna River, a tributary of the Susitna, which drains Ptarmigan Valley, the area in which Rainy Pass Lodge is located. This is the junction of the Skwentna River and Happy River. Finger Lake, one of the many beautiful jewel-like lakes that lie along our path. And as we enter the Alaska Range, the canyon gets narrower, the lakes get smaller. It's a verdant land, beautiful to behold. And we pass Red Salmon Lake, where Dennis is located on this particular day with his hunter. We see the aircraft far below us. And enter Ptarmigan Valley itself. King Frost has hit the land. The colors have begun to change. They are many and varied. Beautiful sight to behold. Of course, the coniferous trees, which in our country are spruces only, never change color, but the birches and the cottonwood and the willow, all are vivid yellows and browns and reds, contrast with the blue of the water and the green of the spruce. A beautiful sight for us to see. And the valley gets narrower as we enter Ptarmigan Valley, and some 20 miles up we come to Puntilla Lake, on which Rainy Pass Lodge is located. It's just a tiny scar in a mighty wilderness, but it will be home to us for the next 3 weeks. Ptarmigan Valley is a U-shaped valley about 100 miles long, which reaches clear through the Alaska Range. It is the greatest natural habitat for big game in North America, for here is found all types of cover and terrain and altitudes and feed for all the different types of animals. And as we come in for a graceful landing, we realize that at last our adventure has really begun. And the widgeon slowly falls off the step, and we turn and taxi toward the parking area. And the wheels are down, and we come out of the water and turn and stop. We have arrived. And that evening, we enjoy the conventional American relaxation hour called the cocktail hour. Our companion hunters, Russ Wildman, Pete Schmidt, all the boys who are here to hunt with us, all the guides, and our hostess and our cook, all join in song. Joe plays his guitar for us, and Leo directs. I want to tell you now that without Leo, the director, we would have been lost. The only thing we need for him to get into the mood of things is a couple of, no, just one boy on the guitar. This is Pete Schmidt. He's a great hunter and comes to Rainy Pass almost every year. And Russ Wildman. Russ comes every 2 years. He's been hunting with Bud for many, many years. Great companions to be with. Next morning, bright and early, we get out and watch the activity around the camp. Our first adventure will be for Dall Sheep. And the other hunters are also going out to the different camps, of which there are about 15 in the area, and the small aircraft piloted by Jim and Dennis and Joe are taking the various hunters and guides out to the different camps, where they will stay for 2 or 3 or 4 days. Lee is lying inside the spread of his moose's antlers. Guide. Now the work really begins. They had to skin out these fellows, prepare them for picking up with a tractor later on. And then they started home, and night overtook them, and they made a Siwash camp on the bluff on the bank of Happy River. And Jimmy went on home, and Dennis and Jimmy brought back some sleeping bags, and they crawled into them and slept for the night. And this is Leo in the early morning, putting his pants on. What, no modesty? What's the matter with you, guy? But they had a fine time, and it's a night they will always remember. Very tired bodies. As they made their way across the cable to get on the lodge side of the river, they're very happy that it was there, because the river is in flood stage, very high, very turbulent. Rest right in the middle. We sit on top of Long Lake Hills and look at the country. The panorama spread before us is breathtaking, for it contains every type of big game indigenous to North America, practically, except goats. And back in camp, Leo displays his beautiful trophy, which is very high in the record class, by the tent. This is at Styx Lake, far up the valley. And Bobby, too, gets into the picture. We meet some of the other hunters again. In the early morning, come out to say our goodbyes. This is in the boneyard, that part of the yard where all the trophies are piled so that they may dry in the sun. And a little horseplay and a little fun among the guides and hunters. Bud and Jean, Joe and Bill and Dennis and Jim all gather around us, for this is the day that our hunt is over. This is the romance of the wilderness. And embark for Anchorage. Bud and Joe will be our pilots. We fly into the sunset. Good hunting, good companions, a time we will always remember in Alaska Grapeland.